In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a movie with your iOS device. Begin by using your iOS device as a video camera. Then use iMovie on your iOS device to edit the film. And then we'll upload the finished film to Google Drive to share with our audience. When you use the camera app on your iOS device to shoot video, it automatically saves the file to your camera roll. Here are some clips that I shot yesterday of my 11-year-old daughter and her new pair of rollerblades. I want to make a short movie with these clips on my iPod Touch, so I'm going to open the iMovie app. If you don't have iMovie, you can get it on the App Store for $5. When iMovie opens, press the plus button, and then click New Project. Now we have an empty project to work with. The first thing I'll do is add some of the video clips that I shot from my camera roll. When I click on the Add Media button, I can access all the video, photos, and audio on my mobile device. I'll scroll down to the first clip that I shot and tap to select it. Now I drag the circle at the front to select my beginning frame. Then I drag the circle at the right to select the ending frame. Click the blue arrow to insert the clip into your timeline. You can scrub through the content by sliding the clip back and forth. Okay, now I'll show you what happens when you add a second clip. Again, I'll use the yellow buttons to select the starting and ending frames. Click the blue arrow to add the second clip to your timeline, but this time you'll notice a cross dissolve has been automatically added. Tap the cross dissolve twice, and you can modify its duration or remove it. Now my short movie is beginning to take shape. I'm going to add two more clips really quickly. Now I have four clips in my movie with cross dissolves between each clip. To add a fade in at the beginning of the movie and a fade out at the end of the movie, I'm going to click on the Settings button. Set the Fade In and Fade Out buttons to On. Press the Play button to see the fade. Press the Play button again to stop playback. Now I'd like to add a title to the beginning of my movie. Tap twice on a clip to open the clip settings window. I select Title Style and choose Opening for a title at the beginning of my movie. I enter the text and click Done. Press the Play button to see how your titles turned out. Next, I'm going to do some work with the sound. Click the Add Media button and select Audio. You can choose from a variety of iMovie theme music, sound effects, or even your own music library. Preview audio with the play button on the right. When you tap to select, the music will drop into your timeline. For most of my movie, I only want the music to play, not the location sound. To adjust the audio for any clip, tap the clip twice to bring up the clip settings. You can adjust the volume for a clip with the slider, or turn it off completely. After turning off the sound on the remaining two clips, my movie's done. When I press the play button, I can watch the whole movie and see how it looks and sounds. When I'm happy with the content of my film, I click the My Projects button to go back to the main window. From here, I can export my finished movie to the camera roll. Click the Share button at the bottom of the screen and select Camera Roll. Then select the resolution of your film. The higher the resolution of your film and the longer your movie is, the more time it'll take to export. So be patient. The next thing I want to do is upload my video to Google Drive so that I can share it with others. You can get the Google Drive app for free on the App Store. Use your RVSchools email address and password to log into Google Drive. I made a folder on my Google Drive for personal videos, so that's where I'm going to save my film. Click the plus button, select Upload Photos or Videos in the dropdown. Choose the camera roll and select the finished video. Then click the check mark at the top. Depending on the size of the file and the speed of your internet connection, this can take some time, so again, be patient. When the upload is complete, your movie will appear in your Google Drive. Click on the info icon to bring up the details for the file. Tap the Rename button and enter a new title, like the one I just misspelled, and click Rename. To share your file with others, click the Share icon. Add the email addresses of the people with whom you'd like to share and give them editing, commenting, or viewing rights. When your list is complete, click on the blue check mark in the top right corner. Click on the X to back out of the file details, and use the arrows in the top left to back all the way out to the main menu for the app. If you're using a shared iOS device, make sure that you sign out of the Google Drive app before you give the device to someone else. And finally, here's the finished movie.